John Smith speaking. I first sighted the James River in the year 1607. The largest of our three vessels was the Sarah Constance. Battered by storms all the way from England, we were weary after months at sea. So we watched the sun go down over this strange land. Although a prisoner in chains under false charges, I was eager to tread dry land once more. All our company waited until morning. We wished to secure a place for our settlement which would not offend the natives. Peering into wooded shores, we saw this land was almost an island, but we thought it a natural fortress. We had chanced into a land as God had made it. Here was opportunity, a new world, a virgin paradise. Now, no longer a prisoner, I too went ashore to stride on earth again. And to smoke my pipe in peace, I abate. Good to be free and sight green things again. Yea, and wondrous birds. Wild animals seem to be most numerous. Good to tread steady ground. I walked about, seeking what the land would hold. Strange fruits, richly smelling. Here was our new Eden. And serpents in this Eden also. Aye, danger here. It takes watching. Life will not be sweet and easy. We must be alert for all enemies. Aye. What is this monster, so tame he regards me not? I'd seen bears before as curiosities in England. Strange birds, turkeys they're called. I must explore this island. Wild vines, a confusion of shrubs. Perchance they may be grapes. Aye, come autumn, they'll be ripe. And this small river divides us from the mainland, a natural moat to our island fortress. This expanse of water might hold back the Indian. Trust. Here be our paradise, Virginia. Then went every man to his work with axes and saws to build our fort and erect our city. We took delight to hear the trees thunder as they fell. And on the first Sunday, we erected our first church, a sailcloth tent. And we dedicated this spot to the glory of God and called it Jamestown. While the fort was building, I raised sail on a small barge. I was ordered by our council to seek out lands from whence the river came. In honor of our gracious king, we called it the James River. The wind was fair. We bore along on a bright May morning. Lying ahead was gold, mayhap, or away to the southeast. Who knows? Still our breeze held. We kept alert for signs of savages. We searched every point and bay for harbors and habitations. Now the wind died. The river narrowed. Our way was blocked. Here water fell down through rocks, so perforce we waded ashore. A land of stones with no deep water to float a boat. What's this? Has the glitter of precious ore. Then this. No, by St. Nicholas. No, not gold. So on a nearby hill where today stands the city of Richmond, we set up a cross, and I marked it down. This much we knew about our brave new world. A large, deep river runs west to the rocks. What lies here? To find another route to the South Seas, I explored north. To me, this appeared a great sea. Chesapeake, the Indians called it. Their name for great water. St. Christopher, the Indians were right. Oh, this is a landlocked bay, shallow, full of sudden squalls. We bore north for several days, then hove about and headed south along the western shore. I so marked it. From whence came this new river? From what unknown land? Here we came upon fish so plentiful, we attempted to catch them in a frying pan. Failing this, we endeavored to spear them with our swords. With small result. We voyaged to this spot, where today stands Fredericksburg. Rocks again. Again we sought gold. No avail. With smaller craft, I searched further. With three men, I went up a winding river, different from the others I'd seen so far. Our progress was slow. This was the Chickahominy. It appeared to hold a threat of evil. But the council at Jamestown had directed me to explore this stream to its head. Here again we sighted strange birds, curious animals. Our way wound and circled through skeleton trees. I felt that hostile eyes were watching, so remained in the center of the stream to avoid enemy arrows. But the banks ahead closed down upon us. Land we must. Ordering my men to stay behind, I went forth alone, seeking game. All is not well here. Aye, faith. St. Christopher, a near thing. More of them. My friends. Yes, this might interest them. Now, here's a marvel. Needle points ever north. I was a captive, so they paraded me from village to village before bringing me to their chief, Pocahontas. I confused them with wonder. To them, my color was white like oyster shells. Pardon for some of that tall corn. My people are hungry back in Jamestown. Yes, now I must face Chief Pocahontas. Long had I hung my life over the teeth of danger, so misfortune could never happen to me. It seems. But this appears serious. They plan something. This bodes not well. It cannot be true that I am to die here. I am John Smith. No, my good luck still held. The chief's daughter, Pocahontas, saved me. She was 12 then. In this statue, she appears to have grown older. I, John Smith, recall also, on the north bank of the York River was the main village of Powhatan, called Werewocomico. He demanded we build him here an English house. This is the chimney of that house of Powhatan. Still standing today, plastered with its marble. Our new city of Jamestown was now stoutly encircled by a palisade. The church reared its steeple. Now president of the colony, I preserved strict order to prevent my people from starving. Food must be had, so I went forth. South from the James and the Nansemond River is Dumpling Island. There the Indians had a great store of corn. Here was food also. guns, the Indians splashed away up these small streams. We had destroyed their canoes out in the river. From here, they watched us. And their corn remained hidden on the island. So, except for our ducks, we were hungry. We camped for the night, building a large fire to keep off the winter chill. Afterward, we raked away the coals. This left the ground very warm. And on this ground, we slept till morning. A mile up the river from Jamestown is a sandy point. Here we set about a new venture. The sand seemed good. There were trees for firewood, sand for glass. Here we built the first factory in the New World. Long fearing the Spanish ships might attack us, I went forth again in a canoe, up a stream across the river from Jamestown. Here we built a new fort, where the Spaniard could not come close with his cannon and galleons. We built the fort upon this high commanding hill, overlooking the winding creek, facing a wide expanse of marsh, a fort hard to be assailed and easier to be defended. Some weeks later, I was in our sailing barge on a visit to friendly Indians when an accident befell me that governed the course of my life. I had not closed my powder flask. In my pain, I leaped overboard and nearly drowned. But I lived. The burn was deep. To seek London surgeons, I left Virginia for the deeds of other men. I was destined never to return to Jamestown, nor view the settlement's growth. I was never to bargain with the treacherous Powhatan. But I left the colony well provided for. As for Pocahontas, she married John Rolfe and was presented in London to King James. But my spirit ever remains in Virginia. I first looked upon her wide-flung rivers. I was one of her first sons. I saw the many opportunities in this far-reaching land. I was the first Englishman to chart and explore the edge of our strange new world.